Hi. Hi.
So this is going to be a review on my Carrera Virtuoso. So I brought this probably May time last year. You see 2021 version. Now I've covered the Carrera name up on there and all the Virtuoso logos, because although I like the bike, it's not, well, the parts on it aren't very good, so I wouldn't necessarily recommend it as such if anybody goes and buys it. Main reasons why, I'll go through the bad reasons first. The actual crank set was just a cheap stamped steel one, and the chain rings were warped, so no matter how I set the front derailleur, the chain was always rubbing, so it was always making noise when I was cycling. It wasn't always a problem, it was mainly a problem when you were putting a lot of power down. It would then flex even more and make more noise. So I had to switch that out and, if I took it back to Halfords, I'd just get the same replacement, so there wouldn't have been much point in doing that. So I switched out for a Shimano Claris with the Holotech bottom bracket, and that's been perfect. I mean, that's like a 70 pound upgrade, the bottom bracket and the crank. So that's quite a lot considering the price of the bike, which is like, was it 350 or something like that. So the front and rear derailleurs are Shimano Claris. That's why I went with the Shimano Claris chain set. And I've had absolutely no problem with the Shimano Claris chain set whatsoever, works fine. I've got them on my other bike as well and works fine. I've done over 2,000 miles on this bike now and it's been really good. The furthest I've cycled on it is around about 90 miles, and haven't had many problems with cycling that far. It's quite comfortable to ride actually. The one thing, when I got this bike, the tyres on it, on them, I can't remember, I think it says 28C, but they are a lot smaller than 28C, so I think Halfords possibly got a deal on a load of tyres which were misprinted, probably, because on the inside of the tyre, it actually states that they're 23C. The first tyre I went out on this, I had the tyres pumped right up, and my back was absolutely buggered when I got home. I wish I hadn't gone out on it, because I'd done about 30 miles on it, and my back was absolutely killing, just because of the road being so rough where I live. So I had to change the tyres as well. So if you do get this bike and you find out it's a really hard ride, yeah, change the tyres. There's no other bad points about it as far as I can tell in the 2,000 miles that I've rid it. Other thing that I did upgrade, I upgraded the stem to a Redshift shock stem. Now, I originally went for this one because I've got a bad back, I wanted the handlebars up higher. So that's what I got, and works really well because I also get a wrist pain, and that's really helped out. Also, I just added a little rear view mirror here because I like to see what's behind me, because there's a lot of traffic where I live and it helps out a lot. The disc brakes, they are just cheap mechanical. Tetro Micra 160mm rotors. I found them to be, you know, sufficient. I wouldn't say they're as good as rim brakes, although in the wet and winter weather they are a lot better than rim brakes. So yeah, when the rims get coated in mud, it doesn't reduce your performance, because obviously you've got discs instead. So they are, you know, a good thing. But yeah, they definitely haven't got as much power as rim brakes. But I mean, saying that, possibly if I changed the pads to something better, some better quality pads, they're the original pads that came with it, they possibly might be better. The seat that came with it was way too hard for me. I couldn't ride it with that. It's just like sitting on a piece of wood, basically. Actually, a piece of wood might have been more comfortable. The handlebars are a 42 width handlebar. I haven't had any problems with them as such. I would have liked, because I usually have 44 width handlebars, but they work okay. And also the shifters, that's Shimano Claris as well, the newer style ones without the cables coming out the side, so they go underneath the grip tape. Yep, they work absolutely brilliantly, had no problems with them. So the wheels, when I got them, they were slightly out of true, but I trued them up with spoke key and they were fine. I did actually have my, I didn't have my bike assembled at Halfords, so it came in a box all flat packed, so I had to put the handlebars on and put the wheels on, and that's all you have to do to set it up. Yeah, the wheels, they were slightly out of true when I got them. I trued them up and they've been fine ever since. I did actually try a set of 650B wheels in here, and they fit fine, so I am thinking about getting a set of 650Bs so I can put fat tyres on here for winter. Anything else yet? So the forks on this bike are aluminium. I kind of prefer the aluminium forks to carbon fibre, just because I've heard so many stories about carbon fibre forks failing. It kind of puts me off. I think if I was ever to get a more expensive bike, I'd probably go for a titanium bike with titanium forks. But yeah, forks, everything's been fine. I mean, I haven't had any problems with it, really, issues apart from those initial ones with the crank set and the tyres, really. Overall, I mean, it's a comfortable bike to ride, I've got to admit. The geometry of the bike itself is quite comfortable. But yeah, overall, I'm pretty happy with the bike itself now, anyway. Haven't had any more problems with it. I probably am going to paint the frame at some point. Just so I can get rid of all the Carrera decals. Yeah, since I've done all those upgrades, I've put about 1,500 miles on it and haven't had any problems with it. At the moment, I've got some the Kenda tyres, which came on my Pinnacle Neon bike. So yeah, not a good bike initially, but yeah, not a bad bike either if you're willing to put some extra money into it. So yeah, that's my review of the Carrera Virtuoso. Please comment and subscribe, be much appreciated, and I hope you're all taking care at the moment, and I hope you're all well. So I'll see you next time, bye.
All right.